Hey, this is Akebono Gregory Monovitz Jr. This is show number, oh, this is not a podcast. How are you all doing? I know I haven't done a podcast in probably about a month, but that's usually the schedule I'm sticking to. Today is going to be a review on gaming, or actually more in particular, a Raspberry Pi, which is inside this Nintendo cartridge. Now, what is a Raspberry Pi? A Raspberry Pi is a handheld computer, as you can see here from this quick clip, that was invented in England for small-time computing. It's got a HDMI cable, it's got Wi-Fi built in, it's got a couple of USB ports, and a power cable, which I'm gonna hook up here in a second. Now, the computer costs about $30, but you're gonna need accessories. So you're gonna, unless you already have it in your inventory, you're gonna need an HDMI cable or some kind of way to connect to a TV source or a computer monitor. And then you're gonna need a USB keyboard. And then this looks like a Super Nintendo controller, but it's not. It's actually a USB controller. And I got all of these items on Amazon.com. Now the computer itself, the Raspberry Pi, is only about $30, but you can buy a kit or a bundle, which will probably run you around $50 or $60 or something like that. Now, I bought this off of a Kickstarter from a guy who made this classic looking NES cartridge here. So I actually paid more for this than the average person. This was about $80. You'll also need an SD card as well. I'll link all this in below for you if you're interested. So why am I doing this video? This video is for retro gaming, since that seems to be the cool thing right now. You've got your classic Nintendo that's out right now with the 30 games built in. Well, this Raspberry Pi can hold hundreds or even thousands of games depending on the size of your SD card. And how it does that is it runs an emulator. An emulator is a software program that mimics the original hardware. Now, most of these emulators work pretty well, but some of them don't, as I'll explain here for a second. So, and here's a list of all the systems it supports. Now, it doesn't mean it's going to always work, because that also depends on the ROMs, and the ROM stands for read-only memory. I won't try to get too much into technical mumbo-jumbo, but if you're working around computers enough, you know what it is. But a ROM is basically the software of the video game itself. Now, as a legal thing, I cannot give you any links to any ROMs because you have to legally own the original game. Hint, hint, wink, wink. But a lot of these games, their copyright has expired, so you might be able to get away with that. But I'm not gonna, just for legal purposes, I'm not gonna link you up for any ROMs. So everything I'm showing you right now is completely legal. And like I said, I'll have the link below. So, so we're gonna go ahead and power up here. And here we go. Little tricky. Eyes aren't what they used to be, so had to bear with me for a second. And we'll just quickly go through some of this. So as you see, it is booting up. Let's do a little adjustment here. There we go. There we go. Now what this is it's running a free operating system, Linux, and it's called RetroPie. So it's a RetroPie operating system sitting on top of the Raspberry Pi hardware. And this is all written by some smarter than me folks in England. And then the emulation station splash screen you saw is the front end to access these games. So basically, you transfer your ROMs through to this Raspberry Pi, which can be done over Wi-Fi. And depending on the ROMs you have, these different systems will show up. Now, this is nowhere close to all the systems, as I said earlier. But right now, I've got some games for Atari 5200, Atari 7800, Commodore 64. Yes, I got Commodore 64. As you see, I got like 27 games. And this is Final Burn Alpha. This is a arcade emulator. It does well with some arcades and not so well with others. Pretty much, this is the go-to emulator for 90s versions arcade. and MAME, which has been around for years for the PC. These are going to run a lot of your old school arcades. And there's a couple different versions, and it's a trial and error. Depends on what you want to play with. But we got one MAME here with two games, and this one here, I've got eight games installed. And then we got some Genesis, got 57 games for the Genesis. And then the NES, the classic NES, you got 102 games on there. And then RetroPie, which is a config, we're gonna come back to this here in a second. And we got Genesis 32X, so the extra horsepower for original Genesis, and Super Nintendo games. So let's show you some of the RetroPie setups. Very easy, GUI. You can set up your audio, your Bluetooth, if you got any Bluetooth controllers. You got different themes that you can set up on here. You can also download more if you need be. I make this project as simple as I can. I don't try to get too crazy, because you can put all kind of extra stuff on here. Your file manager, your file, Raspberry Pi config. This is where you'll do any kind of configurations if you're installing or changing anything. As you see, this is a 2E, which is a text user interface instead of a GUI. You heard of a GUI? This is a text user interface here. And I've got it set up here to my controller, so we can just back out of that, finish that. And I'm not even sure what RetroArch is. Launch is a GUI, so you can change RetroArch. I think RetroArch is another front end emulator to your or front end software to your emulator. Like I said, I am new to this, so the fact I've made it this far to me is a miracle. People say, well, you work in IT, you work in computers, but man, this is all software configuration stuff I don't mess with. But so far, it's really been easy to set up. Another thing you spend a lot of time in here is a RetroPie setup, which is gonna take you to another 2E here. And you get your basic install. You don't wanna mess with that. We're on the latest version, 4.21, which I did about 8 days ago. And this is where you'll install any optional packages or anything. When in doubt, go to YouTube. YouTube's your friend, or the GitHub website where you can download RetroPie from. And I, like I said, I'll have all these in the links below to this particular show right here. So we're gonna exit back out of that. So just showing you stuff real quick. If you're very savvy with the keyboard, you can do that. It shows your IP. I've got this on my Wi-Fi network, so I don't have to constantly keep taking the SD card, which is inside the RetroPie, taking it in my computer, transferring ROMs, and coming back. I am good to go. It's all set up right here. So it's very, very, very convenient to work with. Oh, sometimes it does that. It'll pop into another menu because it keeps refreshing the screen so nothing gets burnt in. Not that burning's really an option. And then splash screen, you can change your boot up screen here. It's so funny because you get this nice GUI, and then it takes you into this old school 80s looking 2E. If you've been using computers in the 80s or heck, even some of the 90s, but you can change all that stuff in here. You can even download extra ones right from here, because this is on the Wi-Fi. This is on the internet. So enough of this yapping. Why don't we show some video games here, right? So let's go. The Atari 5200, I'm not gonna show you. I'll show you what games I've got installed. I got one game on there right now, because this emulator is somewhat of a pain in the butt to work with. You know what? I'm gonna go and show you what it does here. So I'm launching the game here. I'm pressing A, and then it takes you into this old school looking menu here, definitely from the 80s, because that's when the 5200 came out. I believe it was like very early 80s. And you gotta come in here, and so the keyboard, you gotta load this cart here, and then there's my game. And that took a while just to get that. I had a bunch of screens, I had a bunch of games that I was trying out on here, and it wasn't working. So that's Pitfall's version on the Atari 5200. Now the Atari 7800, I'll just show you what I got here for a game list. Not, like I said, I'm still very new at this, so not a whole lot. This one went right into Donkey Kong. I don't know why I did that. I wanted to show my game list. There we go. So I got Donkey Kong, Donkey Kong Jr., Galaga. And what's cool is that I can get game art for this right through the menu. So you go here to the Scraper program. Now this one's a little tedious to work with. And I want to do only missing images, but right now it's going to hit all the systems. I don't want it to hit all the systems. I only want it to hit the 7800 because I've got a lot of these game arts already scraped. So, and this is just to make it look somewhat nicer. So we're going to hit start here, and there it goes. It goes to this games.dbnet site, and it finds some of the box art for it. So we'll go ahead and select that for Donkey Kong. We'll go ahead and do all these 7800s, and there we go for the 7800. Not even honestly with you if I'm gonna play much of 7800, because the 7800, as you know, was just one of Atari's last attempts of releasing a console too late to the game to Nintendo. These were all available on the Nintendo, or a lot of these games were available on the Atari 2600, so somewhat better version graphics of the same games. And as you can see here, couldn't find Ms. Pac-Man, and a lot of that's contingent on what you see there, game 6 of 8, Ms. Pac-Man, a lot of that's contingent on the title itself, but it couldn't find it, so we're gonna go ahead and skip that. And then one-on-one basketball, remember that with Larry Bird and Dr. J, so we'll go ahead and put that on there. And we got one more here, Summer Games, one of my favorite Epics games from the 80s, but I prefer to play this on the Commodore. So we got 7 games successfully scraped, 1 game skipped. Now, as you see here, it looks a lot easier to look for, you know, and it gives you a write-up of the games. So a little tedious. There are scraper programs out there that I've been toying around with, and it's hit or miss. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. But, you know, like I said, there's Ms. Pac-Man, we didn't have anything. But, so yeah, there's some of the Atari 6800. Let's show you what Donkey Kong looks like. It just looks like a bad version of the arcade. It's not all that great. So we're gonna go down here and select standard, and then one player. We definitely don't want advanced because I'm not that good at this game, never was. So we'll go ahead and hit start. And here we go, here's the load screen. So there you go, there is an Atari 7800 screen, and it's a little buggy, but froze up on me. So I'm getting out of that. I will probably get rid of a lot of these 7800 games. I probably won't even use it at all. So once I remove the ROMs off of here, it's gone. All right, and people are probably wondering, oh, where's the 2600 games, Greg? Well, I have a library of Atari 2600 games that I bought on my Xbox One. So why load them up twice? I mean, it might be kind of cool to put on here. We'll see, but not gonna mess with the 2600 games right now because I already have it on my Xbox One. And I tell you what, as much as I appreciate growing up in the video game era, some of those games are just flat out bad. But when you're a kid in the 80s and you knew nothing else except for comparing to an arcade, you actually made the best of it, and we had a lot of fun out of it. I remember talking with my friends, we would look at the box art. You know, you see some of this box art and like, man, one day video games will look like that. Well, we've exceeded it if you've been around. And what's cool about this interface I got here, this theme, I should say, this isn't the default theme. I was able to change this within the RetroPie config, and you can get the picture of the console there, and then of course there's the 7800. But let's go into Commodore, huh? One of my favorite computers in the 80s. As you see, I did do some scraping here. So I got Archon, Archon 3, Archon 2. Some of these are repeats of each other. Like I said, don't have all the art for or all the information for every single one of these, but I'm just quickly scrolling through. Oh, there's that bug again. It keeps taking me out of these screens here. There we go. And then Possible Mission, Mule. Oh, great game. My sister and I played the heck out of the game. Played a lot of this Raid on the Bungalow Bay, Silent Service, good old Subway. Submarine game, Subway. I am hungry. So I'm doing this before I go out for union meeting tonight. And then of course some of my favorites here. Summer Games 2, Winter Games. Oh, had a lot of fun with that game. And World Games, and I think I put California Games up here too. Quickly glance over that. But one of my favorite games was this chess-like game here called Archon. We're gonna go ahead and load it up, and you're gonna see some screens you probably haven't seen in a long time. The thing about this emulator is that it's emulating the Commodore 64 hardware. So you are, it's it's a little slow is what I'm saying, so you gotta be a little patient. They actually put a boosters in this to speed it up somewhat, but remember, the whole point of the emulation is that the ROM code has not changed since probably 1984, or since this was cracked. They at least in the emulator put a version in here of, and I'm still trying to figure out some of the keys here. Oh, there we go. There's the game. And it's a little, like I said, it's a little slow, but you know, for being free 99, you know, I can't complain and don't have to mess with all this old hardware. Some people prefer the actual original hardware, but I like the all-in-one approach with this retro because, like I said, I've got a 64 gig card in here and they are such small files. It's like, why not put this all on here? So there's the configuration for this emulator. Like I said, I haven't completely figured out all the controls yet. It would probably help if I looked at the if I looked at the manual. But let me see here. We got joystick. They said use joystick 2 for configuration. And we got the numpad. We got joystick. I'm gonna go with the numpad option here and see if that does anything. And I forgot one of these keys gets this thing to actually run. I'm just hitting a bunch of random keys on my keyboard right now. I know that's sad, right? Supposed to be doing a video review here. Like I said, it's emulating the keyboard, so I have to figure out exactly which one of these is, you know, I think, do I got it here? No, that's not gonna work, but that's okay. We'll go ahead and get out of here, but it gives you an idea. I just have to get the controls pretty much set up. But so that's just a sample of games right there on the Commodore. Sorry, I haven't showed you any like actual gameplay yet, but do I have anything under here for, I'm toying around with, this is the final burn off of this arcade game. Some of these work, some of them don't. Let's try Satan's Hollow here, see if it works or not. So this is the actual arcade game for this. See, look, it didn't load up. So I scraped and didn't work. I think Zaxxon is the only one working on this Final Burn Alpha. Like I said, the Final Burn Alpha is more for the 90s. So we'll go ahead and load up some coins here and hit start. And here we go. Here's Zaxxon. It's just a good old side scroll or angled scroll shooters. My uncle introduced this game to me in the 80s and loved it. And there was a follow-up with Super Zaxxon. Don't have those ROMs, but I will once I figure out what's going to work here. But yeah, here's good old Zaxxon. I have spent a lot of quarters on this game. I look back to these old games and I'm like, boy, did I dump a lot of tokens and quarters in this game. So there we go. Got through the first level here. I think I'll go against these fighter planes here, and they're gonna shoot at me, and shoot right back at them. It's like, what you got? So, and then we'll come right back into a new level. So there's Final Burn Alpha, and we're back out of here. And MAME, I'm playing around with this. The Donkey Kong, and this is known, the sound isn't exactly right here on the Donkey Kong. Let's turn it up here a little bit. Let's coin up. So you got the sound here, but when he hits the deck, you don't get the banging. So you got the sound, but nothing there. So, and then even Mario, that doesn't work either. But, you know, again, for free 99, I can't complain. Supposedly there's a fix out there. It's like I said, it's trial and error. You gotta find the right ROM. So this MAME works a little more. I believe this Tron 625 is the one that works. So I'm gonna have to delete those other two Trons. And that's a load up screen there, nothing to worry about. There you go. There is Tron, probably one of my favorite arcade games of the 80s, especially from the cabinet. The cabinet was absolutely superb. It's funny, this game made more money in quarters than the movie did itself, because the movie was niche. It was a niche thing. Either you loved it or you hated it. Most of the reception was hated. I have not set up the controllers on here, so this is not working right now, but that is MAME. That's the thing. You got to go into these MAME controllers and set up a lot of stuff. And then Genesis. Let's look at all these Genesis games I've downloaded. I got Afterburner 2. I haven't scraped the arcade classics, but let's see what arcade classics is. I just saw that. I'm like, what is this, old school for the Sega Genesis here? What do we got? All right, a movie on these startup screens here. I'm loading it up. Baker Associates production of the classics. All right, I see a little centipede in there. Maybe Missile Command. Copyright 1995, 1996. So let's see what we got here. So this controller is easy to set up because there's nothing to it. It's Sega. It was three buttons. Oh, so look, we got Centipede, Ultrasonic, Missile Command, and Classic version. Let's play Centipede. Pick Centipede here. And yeah, that's fine. One player, novice. All right, here we go. Ooh, this is the Genesis version of Centipede. Kind of sad. Like I said, hit or miss. The arcade version is definitely better, and you got a trackball, so I'm using this gamepad here. So, you know, it's adequate, but that's okay. And like I said, I just downloaded random ROMs just to test out and see if this works. There's California games again. Duke Nukem 3D. Let's try this one out here. See what this is all about on the Sega Genesis. I was hoping to get the Sega, but I guess it depends on the ROM here. So what do we got? Is it loading? Yes, it's loading. Tech Toy. 3D Realms, all right, so at least you know it's from the developer who did. All right, look at those 1996 graphics. Because I believe that is when Duke Nukem came out. So this game was being on support on the end of life for the Sega Genesis, because shortly after this, the Saturn came out, which wasn't too much of a success, but graphically a lot better than this. I think this ROM this ROM is messed up. So this game actually does look better than what you're seeing here. I'm gonna have to try to find a better copy than that. So, Hardball, my buddy Jeff would like Hardball here. Let's see how this plays, how this looks. Sports Accolade. Oh, that looks a lot better than the Commodore version, from what I remember. Exhibition game. Yeah, let's just start. I don't care who's the team. Play ball. Let's play ball here. There we go. Wow. Looks pretty cool. You know, not bad for an early 90s game, right? All right. Run in the center field. We get it. Hurry up. All right. Looks like I am hitting. All right. Who is that? Contact. Let's go. Sometime today. There we go. Just trying to make contact. Of course, I'm going to swing at the first pitch. That's what I always do. We're just contact. We just want to hit the thing. We're not swinging for the fences. Ooh, got a nice big old high one on me. I'm going to strike out on my first at bat. The motion almost looks real. Oh, way late on that one. Strike out. And I never played this game before, so it's just a matter of playing around. That's a Hardball 95. Ooh, major improvements from before, huh? Mortal Kombat, I was never much into Mortal Kombat. I just, you know, think it was a cool-looking game. Oop, hit the wrong button here. Let's try out the Michael Jackson Moonwalker, though. This was a popular arcade game. We'll see how the port is for the Sega Genesis. For the Mega Drive, as it was known in Japan. Ooh, all right. One player, obviously. Round one, 30. I have no idea what I'm doing here. Oh, this ain't exactly the arcade game. This is a side scroller. I can dig the music, though. All right. Kick. All right, Annie, are you okay? That's what matters. Woo! digging the music though. Oh man. All right. Gotta save Annie here again. Throwing the hat. Kick. All right, there we go. This guy gonna jump me. Might be already dead. No, don't go in there, Michael. What, did I just kick her? All right. I think I'm about to die here. Oh, you killed Michael Jackson. Anyways, there's the Genesis version of Moonwalker. I haven't scraped that, I just downloaded it to try it out. Got the NBA Jams, love NBA Jams. Rolling Thunder. Of course, you can't have a Sega Genesis console without all the Sonics. Huh? Let's try one of these. Just a quick game review here. Not even quick, because we're almost going 30 minutes on this video. But, you know, just give me any idea. It's like, look at all these great games you can play again for roughly 50, 60 bucks. You don't have to buy that NES cart like I did. I just got that because I thought it looked cool. If not, you can just put it in its own box and, you know, play away. So this one came out in 93. I think I remember this. I never owned a Genesis, though. I was a big Nintendo fan, so I was part of that war back then. It's like, no, I would only play Nintendo, but or only own Nintendo. I'd play Genesis, but now I don't care. I mean, I got PS4, Xbox One. Doesn't matter to me. As long as the gameplay's fun, I'm good. I don't remember this. Do you remember this? Oh, this is one of those puzzle kind of Tetris games. Ah, I see. Let's see. I'll see if I stack them up there. How's that gonna work? I don't even know what I'm doing here. I thought it'd be like Tetris. You stack them up and these guys will go away. Nope, all right. So not what I thought it was, but that's fine. Space Invaders 91, what can you do to Space Invaders to make it more cool? What do we got here? Sega? All right, Star Trek, did I accidentally hit Star Trek? Playmates was a contractor of Star Trek. Yeah, I hit the wrong button. So, it scraped it wrong. That's all it is, wrong scraper. So, that you know, like I said, the graphic is not contingent of the game. That's part of the scrape here. Now, I found this interesting. Super Mario Brothers on the Sega Genesis, their arch nemesis. This has got to be a hack someone did. So, let's see what this looks like. And the Sega Genesis was comparable to graphic power of the classic Nintendo, so this should look about the same. This looks more Super Mario 2-like, but this is definitely a hack, because you see no restricted on there or anything. Nintendo would have never approved this. So, gameplay-wise, about the same. The characters look the same. Oh, jumping on the shells does not work. Interesting. Oh, I instantly have Fireball. Wow, okay. Yeah, is this gonna work on the mushroom guy too? No, look, that kills you. What's up with that? Definitely a hack. Because, look, it doesn't even break the bricks. I just went right through it, so let's Fireball these guys. All right. Oh, you only get so many of those. So I gotta avoid from here on out. Is that gonna work? Go down. Nope. We'll avoid. Ooh. Oh, you got hearts here. I see that. Wow. Never know what you're going to discover out there, right? So someone made a Mario for the Sega Genesis, but not exactly Mario itself. Now, what is this Super 1501? I just downloaded this. Let's see what we got. Oh, bunch of old games here. Wow, let's try out Ms. Pac-Man. That's always fun. 15-1. Oh, it's a nice splash screen. I like. It's loading. All right. Pack booster. I like pack. Oh, I hit the wrong button. Oh, well. Not exactly the arcade port, but still very, very cool looking game. Actually, arguably looks better than the original. But what can you say about Ms. Pac-Man, right? Let's back at it. Let's go back in here. Unfortunately for this, the only way I know is that you gotta completely go all the way out. What else have we got on here? Shove it, Restless High Sea, Indian Era. I'm gonna have to go through this and probably do another review on this. 15-1. Let's see what this jungle battle's all about. Sounds like Jungle Hunt. Ooh, look at that. All right. Sunset Riders. Gotta love these old looking games, huh? It's so cool now. It looks so bad, but looks so cool. Billy Cool with his weapon Peacemaker. All right. And one player, of course. Woo! All right, we're going after the Commando. All right. Oh, I guess I could have picked Commando. All right. Got my gun here. And gun again. So it's just gun. Those look like lasers, though. What kind of cowboy game is this? These are just lasers. These guys are just rushing me. Oh, one shot. I'm down. Can I kneel? Yes, I can kneel. All right, so we'll kneel. There we go. Oh, I got up too fast. That's what she said, right? Oh, man. So gotta watch those bullets. But there's no jump. So... Oh no, and a cat comes after me. So interesting. And what's on this 19-1? I probably think some of the same games here. Now you see, I've spent a lot of time on Genesis, probably because I didn't own a Genesis. So a lot, holy crap, a lot to play here. There's Pac-Man again. Street Fighter. What, Mario and Sonic? That's gotta be a hack. Street Fighter, let's check out Street Fighter. Oh, did it not wanna start here? Oh, interesting. This ROM doesn't work. No, or maybe it's just that particular game. Let's try Rainbow. Start. See, so it was, that one's a bust. I'm gonna have to remember to get rid of that. But so yeah, there's Genesis, and then of course, arguably one of the best-selling consoles of all time, next to Atari, I believe. Atari still might have the reign on that. But you see, I've downloaded some of my favorites: 1942, Afterburner, Airwolf. Remember that show? Cool show for the 80s. But man, I watched it on YouTube. A couple weeks ago. Oh, so bad. Of course, they had a version of Archon on here for the classic Nintendo. These aren't even all the games. These are just what I picked and choose what we should play with. So let's find a game here that looks interesting, and we will play. How about some good old Burger Time? Huh? That's a good old 80s game. Of course, the system came out in 85. So, you know, I was like, why pay for 30 games when you can play this? And these games are dang near close to the arcade version if you're a purist like that. So it's like, hey, man, you know. Here we go. Gotta make these patties. The only thing that got me about this game is it only gives you so many peppers to throw at this thing. So I guess a lot of this game is strategy to avoid, like, I just busted those guys there. Gets rid of the characters for a second. But there's no jump button, so I got a pepper, look at that. And he got me. So close to the arcade, not exactly, but close. One of my more favorite games that is down here. Ooh, see, there it goes again. Oops. It's switching around on me. Very touchy when it comes to the controller. One of my favorites here was Donkey Kong 3. Now, I've got this game. I've got it on 151 cart. And also, whoa, that is not Donkey Kong 3. Let's see what this does. Whoa, it's a modded version of Donkey Kong 3. All right, so close to it. Don't want to play that. I want to play Donkey Kong 3. So you can come here in a classics, I think. And it might be in here. Oh, this is just the old school Donkey Kong. Again, close. Oh, it's got Donkey Kong and Donkey Kong Jr. So I hit start on this. Now, very, very close to the arcade on this. Let's see if it doesn't do the crawl up screen, which is pretty unnecessary, but at least we got the sound. And I was always terrible at this game. Like still, whether it's a joystick or numpad, I still get stuck. Oh, look, Clark died. Terrible. Donkey Kong Country 4, which is interesting. I'll have to get rid of that 3. That is not 3. So, we'll keep moving on here. Dr. Mario, Excitebike, old school here, man. Just love it. How about Gyrus? Oh, that was a fun game. More simple, too. Less buttons. Trademark of Ultrasoft Corporations. Okay, oh, sounds great. Start. Yep. Love this game in the arcade. Again, close to the arcade, not exactly, but you know. But that's what made Nintendo so popular, because it was a home game console that was very close to the arcade. And it arguably helped, you know, not directly, but kill the arcade industry. As far as arcade going to the arcade, it's like I could stay home now and play games that are damn near close. And then when Super Nintendo and the Sega Genesis came out, that was pretty much it. Then arcades became like this, you know, stigma of smoke and, you know, disgusting people that would or shady looking people, I should say, that would hang out there. So look at these guys here. Warp on. That's the whole thing. You just try to warp on. That's pretty much game. It's like a Space Invaders that you go around and circle with, and you can upgrade, as you saw, to the two shooter there. And then, of course, like I said, I don't have them all loaded up here, but Goonies 2, like that's the Japanese version. And then we had Goonies 2 there, so some of the box art is in there. Laser Invasion. Some of these are just going to be a hit or miss when oops, let me get out of here. So that's Nintendo. Then we got some 32X here, and this was the upgrade to Genesis to put it in the 32-bit category. Now this Afterburner is, I believe, is just like the original arcade. You flew around. There's the Sega. Flew around in an F-14, and they re-release this game on the Xbox 360 and the arcade with updated looking graphics. So this is Afterburner 1. Fun game, and it was one that had that almost dang near 3D like graphics, as you'll see here. I mean, I remember when I saw this as a kid, I was blown away at the arcade. I was like, oh my gosh, look at that, it looks so real. And now you look at it, it's like, really, you think that looks real? So you got guns here with one button, and it flies just like a plane. So up is down is up, fire missiles. But you know what? When you had nothing else to compare this to, this was the bomb, man. Especially when you can, again, play it at home. You know, these systems here, for instance, have pretty much helped kill the arcade. So there's an idea of, I have no idea how to do the speed on this game. Oh, there we go at the bottom. And I got hit. Boom, and then she's getting a little smoke trail. I'm used to think, oh my God, that is so cool. Now it is just so retro. Got the classic Doom on here. Look, I didn't. Some of these didn't scrape right. Mortal Kombat, EA Jam, Pitfall, which is just a bad version. Of course, I gotta have Star Wars on here. Let's play some Star Wars. You know, being a big Star Wars fan, I haven't showed you any Star Wars yet, but here we are. Sega. Notice I'm playing all the Sega games here. I guess because I played so much Nintendo as a kid, I'm kind of making up for it now with this. Now, I have not played this game probably in 25 years. A friend of mine had the Sega Genesis in the Marine Corps and got the 32X. And I remember, again, these get graphics blew me away. I was like, wow, man, look, Star Destroyer. It's like, wow, that looks so cool, but good sound. Let's see what we can do here. Let's play the 32X version, of course. It'll be the pilot. All right, well, Adam Lackbar didn't sound like that. Looks like him. Looks like a screen. Ooh, hyperspace. Ooh, ooh, man, I'm getting sick. Going too fast. Let's slow down. All right, here we go. Kind of reminiscent of the arcade game, which I have. What are we gonna do here? Ooh, do I gotta slow down? There we go. Oh, busted. Now, can I shoot these asteroids? Doesn't look like it. Oh man, I got hit. All right, got speed here. All right, I see. Up and down. There we go. Oh. Messing around with the speed here. I don't know what I'm doing. Those are TIE bombers. Oh, I see, but with my radar. Oh, you can slow down, let them get around you, and then go after them. Shoot. Ooh, slow down. Let them fly past me. There we go. Oh, didn't get them. Going faster. Anyways, there's 32X. I need to wrap it up here a little bit. Some Super Nintendo here. These are the Super Nintendo games I downloaded and tried. Probably one of arguably some of the best. There it goes again. It's my controller that does that. But Super Nintendo and Donkey Kong Country. Oh man, I loved this game. I used to think that graphics could get no better than Super Nintendo at the time because silicone graphics worked on some of the processor in this game. And I mean, it's just like when I saw this, I was like, man, that just looks so good. How did they do that? And luckily, because this is a Donkey Kong or a Super Nintendo controller, the controls are going to be just like how you remember them, if you do, but you got to roll into these guys and kill them. And I believe there was a switch button here because your little pal, Diddy, I believe, can do stuff for you that you can't do. There we go. Oh, you tag team. There you go. Now he's in charge, and he's a little faster. So there's Donkey Kong Jr., and then I think I remember this one, the Diddy Kong Jr. I was hoping for the load screen there. I kind of like the load screen. It might have been this one. Listen. Yeah, this is what I remember, Rareware. And they worked with silicone graphics to make this, and I remember, like, man, look at that. That looks just like a movie. 1995, going away. There we go. That's how I remember it, and I thought it used to look a lot better than that. Very pixelated. But you gotta remember, these games were made for TVs that were a heck of a lot smaller than this. I mean, this is a 4K Samsung. It was never intended to be on a 4K. So the bigger the TV, the more of the stretch of the pixels you're gonna get, because they didn't build in processors to, or into the game code to work with different resolutions and different sizes. It was made for like 32 and smaller, and even on 32 I'm sure it looked pretty bad, whereas, you know, your modern TV system and your games can adjust accordingly. So yeah, pretty much what she's getting. You know, like I said, I'll mess around with this on another time. Super Mario All-Stars, great game. Of course, I got all the Super Star Wars. Look, see, you got some of the box art there. There it goes again. It keeps doing that on me. So that'll pretty much wrap it up for this. I'm going to download a new image for a bunch of games and play with it. I'm gonna have to put it on a separate card because I don't wanna touch this card. I wanna keep this the way it is because this is like my Tinker card. But I found an image that's supposed to have like 5,000 games on it. It's supposed to have a front end, two emulation stations. So a front end on top of a front end on top of a front end. Which will play like video clips of the game and give you a more, I wouldn't want to say classic looking interface, but not so static. So, I mean, like, as cool as this is, imagine seeing a video clip of the game just to give you an idea if you forget, because I don't remember all these games. I mean, there are so many of these games, I just don't remember all of them. So this other image has that already pre-installed. So instead of just, like I said, these static images, it'll have the game in it, and it's called like RoboSpin or something. It's another software that makes it look like a classic arcade all built in. So yeah, that was my review. I should say, I don't want to say quick review because that was like a 45-minute show on the RetroPie. And let me go ahead and take this off the tripod here. So like I said, I've got it all running in this classic cartridge. I paid more for the cartridge than I did from the RetroPie. And then you see they've got power, USB, or HDMI, and then USB, and then hooked into my 4K TV there, as it takes a second to adjust here. So hope you enjoyed that. I'll probably do maybe more specific video here in the future. I'll definitely do a review when I get that 5001 working, but I got to do some research because it's out on one of those torrent sites. I don't know much about hacking. For being working in IT, I don't play around with the hacking all that much. I really don't. So this is Akimoto Greg Imanovich Jr. Thank you for watching this show, and we'll talk to you soon. See ya.